Go.
Hi, my name is Sarah Manikmas.
I'm Matt Hoffman.
Michael Taylor.
Today we will discuss algorithmic research and the implications that it could have on our proposed business push and pedals. First, we're going to give a recap of our previous presentation, explain the country's financial environment, infrastructure, and the marketing information for U.S. businesses. We will also give our proposed business in the South Central American market. To start out, Rhett will cover the
All right, so just a quick overview of our region. South Central America contains Argentina, Colombia, Peru, Uruguay, and Venezuela. I have a quick data set pulled up here of the regional trade statistics with their exports and imports. As you can see, the countries kind of go either way, whether they're in a surplus or deficit. But the total here, they accumulate about $363 billion. Total, 182 of that is imports and 181 is exports, so fairly even throughout the region. Our main exports are metals, both precious and just regular metal, energy solutions, agriculture, and automobile parts, which I'll be getting more into later. Another notable thing to mention is our main trade partners are with the United States right now, China, and Brazil. A couple of regional statistics. So about 85% of the overall population, which is around 162 million people, practice Christianity as a main religion. All of the countries, their primary language is Spanish, but about 93%, or 150 million, use that as their main language, or speak it fluently. And then the population, 86% of this total population lives in urban cities, which we'll also get into a little bit more later. All right, and I'll pass this back to Sarah for the financial environment.
Each of the countries in our region has a different type of currency, and there are a wide range of exchange rates. The type of currency used in Venezuela is the Venezuelan bolivar, and the exchange rate is for $1, there are 36 bolivars. In Colombia, they use the Colombian peso, and for every one US dollar, there are 3,965 Colombian pesos. In Peru, the exchange rate between the Peruvian sol and the dollar is $1 to one or fourth soles. The exchange rate in Argentina is $1 to 361 Argentine pesos, and the type of currency they use in Uruguay is Uruguayan pesos for one US dollar, there are 39. The countries in our region have unstable and fluctuating exchange rates, which presents problems for our business and other foreign businesses who want to expand to that region.
I'm going to be touching on the nature of infrastructure in our region. So first and foremost, we have an issue with transportation. So as you can see over here, I have each country listed, and this is a graph of the paved versus unpaved roads in each of the countries. As you can see, there is an abundance of unpaved roads, which makes it difficult for transportation, especially considering that a lot of the people in this region live in the city. Over here, I have a chart that states that as of 2014, Central Asia, especially Latin America, not Central Asia, did exceptionally poor in terms of funding for the growth of infrastructure. Here I have a little bit about the average commute for an individual living in the region. So on average, these distances over here are how long it takes a consumer to get to and from work, and then the amount of time that it takes them when taking public public means of transportation. The most common is bus routes. They don't have a very prominent rail system. And because of the poor roadways, not many people are able to invest in automobiles. Over here, I wanted to touch on the quality of roads. This region is known for a very poor quality of road standards. The lowest out of all of our countries is Venezuela. On a scale of 1 to 7, they rank 2.6 globally, which is extremely poor. Moving into a little bit of their digital infrastructure, 78% of the region uses the internet or has a device that can access the internet. And smartphones, 122 or 198.9 million people have smartphones, meaning that often one person can have more than one device. Another thing to touch on is the e-commerce in Latin America. Latin America harbors more than 300 million digital buyers, and it's forecasted to grow more than 20% by 2027. It's one of the fastest e-commerce markets globally, and it's said to grow another, or encapsulate 20% of all retail sales in the region by 2026, which is a huge number.
And then taking a look at some of the marketing information for this region, over here is a chart from our paper that takes a look at the foreign direct investment of each country in this region. And you know, Colombia is at the top of this list with a foreign direct investment of a little over $16.67 billion. And then with Venezuela over here, due to the fact that they have economic and political problems throughout this country, it's very unappetizing for countries to invest in this country. So it was hard finding an exact number or any number of the foreign direct investment for that country. Overall, this region totaled a little over $52.25 billion for the year of 2022. And some of the businesses that are found in this region would be like Google, Ford, which would be your automobile parts, as well as McDonald's, Chevron, and Shell. So you're going to see a lot of oil companies or energy companies. And with the picture over here, the top picture is a flurry from McDonald's that is a pre-lean flurry. What is it? What it is it's a little wafer cookie that's rolled in chocolate hazelnut filling inside, and it looks absolutely delicious. And then the bottom picture, Chevron has actually partnered up with the PDVSA, which is Venezuela's national oil company, and they actually work together in 5 offshore and onshore oil projects for that country. And then moving on for our business recommendation for the region.
Our business that we want to bring to this region is Push and Pedals. It's an online e-bike rental company that's accessible through an app. The need that we saw arise in this region is an effective and affordable means of transportation for people to get to and from work safely and efficiently. Our solution is a subscription-based or single-use bike rental company for commuters. So I'm going to go over a couple of the strengths in our SWOT analysis. First and foremost, infrastructure plans. Like I had previously stated, their infrastructure right now is very poor. However, more than $18.6 billion across 56 projects in the region have been declared in 2021, making the region the second largest infrastructure investment commitment in the world. Secondly, the majority of the population is urban. So we have a large market of people living in the city that need to commute. Third, online purchasing. Like I said, e-commerce is booming right now. It's the second fastest growing in the world. Just in Peru, e-commerce has grown 55% since last year, and in Argentina, 87% since 2022. And then lastly, our exports make this business extremely feasible in the region. With metals, energy sources such as lithium and petrol to make our batteries for the bikes, as well as automobile parts. So the pre-existing infrastructure there to manufacture these goods could make it extremely easy for us to manufacture the bikes in the region.
And some of the weaknesses are hyperinflation and poverty, also corruption, bad road conditions, and poor infrastructure, although, as Rhett just said, they are taking steps to improve it. They have a wide collection of humanitarian issues and human rights violations.
And for some of the opportunities, renewable energy, a lot of the countries in this region have invested into ESG initiatives. And so with our company being reliant on energy, our electricity, this would help benefit us because it could draw in attraction from other businesses that also represent or have any ESG initiatives. Another one is cryptocurrency. As we mentioned before, with the fluctuating currencies and unstable or unstable currencies, the opportunity of paying with cryptocurrency will help customers because it offers another way of payment for them that is easier accessible. They have easier accessibility to cryptocurrency than they do with some of their own money. The other one is the other opportunity is with tourist hotspots located throughout this region. This gives us another market to tap into because tourists are then allowed to rent our products and then get a look and feel for the city that they're touring in.
Some threats are the competition between other modes of transportation, such as public buses, cars, motorcycles, etc. Climate change and natural disasters are also threats because they impact the roads and impact the infrastructure as a whole and also the economy. Unstable exchange rates and barriers and restrictions placed on foreign companies who want to expand in that region are also threatened.
And so taking a look at the business model here, again, what we're offering is a e-bike rental service, and customers are able to pay for this either hourly, daily, or seasonally. And they're able to do this through, like I said, crypto, PayPal, or Zelle. And then, again, we'd implement these in the cities where more people are located and are more likely to use these products. And then for promotion, we would like to promote them by having the first ride free for customers. So that could be like a little 15-minute ride just to get people on the bikes and have that experience before they decide to rent it. The other thing we'd also like to offer is seasonal passes. That way, if people do enjoy it and they would like to make this their permanent way to work or to travel the cities, they're able to do so. And then for our advertising and marketing plans, we'd like to start off with some digital advertising, and with a lot more people on their phones down there, it's between, for every 100 subscriptions throughout these countries, it's between 120 and 150 phones that are used for these subscriptions. So again, there's more phones than people. So to reach them on a digital device would be very beneficial to us. And then the other thing we'd like to target is the bus routes. The bus routes currently have a problem with overcrowding. So putting an advertising on the bus or the bus stop where they're at, where these overcrowding problems are located, it allows people to look at an alternative way to travel and commute to work. And then thirdly, our bikes and our charging stations themselves will act as advertisements, because when you are out there on the street and you see one of our bikes go by, you'll associate that with our brand, as well as walking past one of our charging stations. That acts as a giant billboard for us.
In conclusion, based on the research we did for this project, we identified multiple problems within this region, such as the distribution of wealth and population throughout urban and rural areas, economic and political instability, a fluctuating financial environment, bad road conditions, and poor infrastructure. Introducing our e-bike business, Push and Pedals, to the South Central American market will provide consumers with a cheap, convenient, and eco-friendly mode of transportation, which they can use to rely to travel from place to place.